Unfortunately, a lot of Subaru owners have to deal with the warning saying "for safety, auto restart disabled." This happens when the car has shut off the engine using auto start stop, and then instead of automatically starting this engine, the car throws this message and you need to press the engine start button while pressing the brake to keep driving. First of all, when you see this, deactivate the start stop function immediately. In most cases, this message means that your 12-volt battery is almost dead and you may just fail to start your car after one or two start-stop cycles. The problem is that modern Subaru cars have smart alternators. They won't send maximum power to the battery once the vehicle started, as older simple alternators would do. These smart alternators are coded to save fuel and put as little load on the engine as possible. Of course, as with any smart feature in modern cars, the smart charging system fails to notice that the battery is about to die and you get in trouble. People report these issues with fairly new batteries that last up to 1 year and start malfunctioning. Well, first of all, you need to check carefully which type of battery you're using. Most Subaru vehicles need EFB batteries for proper operation. Also, the size and other specs of the battery should be identical to what the manufacturer recommends for your car. Otherwise, the battery will be killed by this smart charging system pretty fast. If you see this message, you may hook up a charger to your 12-volt battery and give it some juice. This will help you solve the problem for some time. Also, if you're driving in very intense city traffic, you better deactivate the start-stop function because it may deplete even a pretty fresh battery very fast. There are various TSBs that instruct dealerships to reprogram the smart charging system, but dealers aren't usually willing to implement them. They will most likely want to sell the new battery to you. This start-stop madness in modern cars has already started an absolutely new industry of various aftermarket devices that help you deactivate the start-stop feature, but if I were you, I would think twice before implementing anything like that in my car. These devices are usually of very poor quality and they interfere with the electrical system in your car. It's not impossible that they fry something and you will have to invest time and money to solve the problem that you've created on your own. So unfortunately, there is no simple fix for this problem. Just deactivate the start-stop more often and charge your battery from time to time.